Hey guys, welcome to the Quad Spot, your spot for the next generation YouTube. I'm Jay.
I'm Dave.
And I'm Steve.
And I didn't mess it up this time. Yeah!
Yeah.
Randy is MIA because we sent him on a secret mission to go recon some new potential guests on the Quad Spot. So today we are joined by our lovely guest, Katie, from All the Lost Ones.
Hey.
So, Katie, for those who don't know about your channel, can you go ahead and give us a little bit of information about it?
Sure. Well, I do daily vlogs on my channel, mainly. Really, my channel, I always describe it as very random because I really don't know what I'm going to do until I turn on the camera. Sometimes I lip sync, or sometimes I'll do acting. It's a random channel. It's the most random daily vlogging channel you will probably ever watch ever in life. And I've been on YouTube for like 4 years doing videos.
Oh, nice.
I have like over 800 and I think I have 890 videos now.
That's quite a bit. Now, before we go into something about boomers, being boomers' wife, which we'll jump into that, just going to ask, there are a few videos in there where you sing an intro. Where did that all start from?
Oh my gosh, that intro, like, What's So Maybe About Katie, or Maybe Katie by the Bare Naked Ladies. That song, I didn't even know it existed until my husband 4 years ago was like, we should make you an intro to your videos. That'd be so cool. And I was like, well, you do it because I'm not doing it. I'm not very good at that. You can do whatever you want. So he picked out the song, and I was like, oh, it's my name. And I freaked out. So it became like this big deal to my channel at the beginning. And I stopped using it because YouTube was like, you can't have copyrighted music. And I freaked out. I thought, oh my gosh, I'm going to lose everything, and they're going to come after me and beat down my door. And so I stopped using it.
It seems like an adopting thing. Like, everyone who starts with copyrighted music, and then they freak out, and then they pick something different as soon as they research the subject.
I've done it.
Yeah, haven't we all?
I mean, I still use it. I still do. And my daughter is obsessed with that song. She's like, Mom, your song's on. They sung that for you. And I was like, yeah. They did. No, they didn't at all. But it has my name, and it's pretty funny because they, in the song, they talk about she has a daughter, you know? Like, oh my gosh, it's like really funny because I have a daughter, and my husband's like, no, it's not written about you. It really isn't.
Are you sure?
I feel like it is. I feel like they knew. They knew that I was going to have a kid. They knew. And they wrote that song. They said, there's going to be this girl named Katie. This is for her.
Now, Jay saying that you're Boomer's wife or something like that? What is this all about?
He asked me to do a collab with him, and I was like, yeah, sure, I'm going to do this collab. I was very excited. I didn't know what I was going to really be doing. He said, oh, you're going to play my wife. And he sent me over the script, and I made the video, and it was actually very difficult for me to make this video because I kept laughing. And so when you see the video, like that take, I think it was like the fifth try because Barry kept making me laugh because for a while I was like, I had to pretend that I'm on the phone and you have to call me. And I would leave the phone on, but like I told him, I said, you're going to have to hang up so I don't hear you on the other end. So instead of hanging up, he would talk on the phone. He kept asking things like, what are you wearing? And I started busting out laughing. I was like, you're ruining everything. So eventually, I hung up the phone. I did it with my cheek, and that way I wouldn't have to hear him talking on the other end. But it was a fun video to make, and I played Boomer's wife. I was going to leave Barry and go fly to Florida and get a new car and all this money. And I actually, in my head, I was like, that's so cool.
Yeah, this money you're supposedly supposed to get from YouTube and all that. Yeah.
Yeah.
So what you're saying is, in other words, Boomer neglected to pay you.
Yeah,
like
I know.
Was supposed to.
I had no money. Yeah, I never saw anything. No.
Boomer,
it's
you're
okay.
Gonna hear from our lawyer, Randy, the crazy Canadian.
Yes, we'll have Randy go take care of him for you. Don't worry about it.
It's okay. We have the quad spot mob coming out for him now. So
no, Jay, we had or Steve, we had to stop that.
We had
apparently when you took our AdSense money, that had to go away.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So, Katie, you have your daughter, your husband, and you basically vlog your whole life. Is that correct?
Pretty much.
What's your favorite thing to do? Now, I see you lip syncing. I see you dancing around the rooms. I see you talking in a dark room with the green screen with the glowing eyes. I mean, so what's your favorite thing to do?
Now the vlogging in the bathroom with the lights off. It actually was something I started when I was doing video responses to another YouTube super course, and he films his videos in the bathroom. So I started doing it, you know, just for like that week. I was like doing these video responses. I'm like, I'm going to win this shirt. I am going to do it. And I was bound and determined to win this shirt, and I did end up winning it. But I was vlogging in my pajamas or something in the bathroom, and I got obsessed with it. And so now I'm the girl that vlogs in the bathroom. And I do it with the lights off because it's better audio quality because the fan is going in the background. And when the lights are on, there's a fan. I can't turn it off. And then also, like, the red eyes is because that flash, it gives me these demon glowing eyes, and I look scary. But I love it. I love those videos. Like, I don't care what anyone says or how often I'm made fun of. I'm like, I love these videos. They make me laugh. And also, it's easier for me to speak my mind because Lily's not around, and I don't like doing my videos around her sometimes because of the things that come out of my mouth.
Oh, yeah.
I can't help it. Word vomit. Bam.
You gotta keep it G.
Yeah, he's four, so, you know.
Go ahead, Steve. So what like inspired you to do YouTube? How'd you get started? Why did you start doing it in the first place? Like, probably much the same way as all of us do it, just because it's fun. But
just kind of happens.
Yeah.
Well, I actually have always wanted to be an actress ever since I was little. And I used to do tape recording, just little tape, you know, cassette tapes long ago.
But what are cassette tapes?
Yeah, I know. Nobody knows.
What are these things anymore?
Children don't know what these are. But I used to record myself doing talk shows. I wish I had those tapes, but I'm glad I don't. But I used to do talk shows. And then when the internet came about and webcams and all that, and we got one, I'd always been fascinated with doing videos or going on anywhere and just putting myself on a camera. I've always loved it. And then I didn't know how to upload to YouTube when that came about, so I knew people post videos here. I'm like, how do they do that? And I'm 15 or something years old going, okay, they're doing this. I know they're doing it. How are they doing it? I know they're, and I couldn't figure out how to upload anything. I had many accounts, there's a cassette tape. That's what mine looked like. But I had many accounts.
Did you have to have a pin to rewind it sometimes?
Yes. Sometimes when it comes out, you have to continue. But YouTube has always been on my mind. Like, I always wanted to post something. So I went to another site, forget what it's called. Don't remember now. I think it was called Zippy Videos. And I uploaded lip syncing videos there. Thank God those are gone. I uploaded stuff there. And then when I finally figured out how to upload videos in 2006, the videos I had on my not 2006, 2007, the videos on there was, they got taken away because of YouTube banning the copyright music. Can't have that. And they were videos Barry had made for me. And so I put them up there. I'm like, oh, isn't this so nice and sweet? Oh, yay, you know, go me with the amazing guy. And now those were gone, but you can find them on MySpace. and then I started vlogging in May of 2008 with my daughter in most every one of my videos. And I would talk about, like, life events and vlog. And I was scared to say any channel names because I was like, people would get yelled at in the comments, you're dropping, name dropping, why are you name dropping? You just want to get views. So I didn't want to be that person. So I'd just be like, I used to watch people and they do this and I can't say names. But I loved the vlogging. I became obsessed and I wanted to do it all the time. I think the first day I uploaded like 4 videos. I think a few of them are gone though. I think I ended up deleting the other 2. I think there's 2 still from that day, but I just kept filming, and I couldn't stop. I was like, no, stop, stop. They don't want to see you 20 million times a day.
Wait. Oh, I've been getting this wrong then, haven't you? Oh, you too, Jay?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm screwed. Dang it. Too much all this?
No, there's never too much all this. I mean, really, come on. I mean, too much all this, it's like too much money. There's no such thing. But you know, there you have to keep them wanting more. So you have to limit that so they come back for it, you know?
That's where you start adding and a bag of chips.
And a bag of chips. You know?
But yeah, that's how I came to be on YouTube. I really wanted to upload back in like 2005 or something when I started seeing more people, but I just didn't know how to do it. So I was like, I don't know what I'm doing.
So thinking about the future, is there something that you're not doing now that you wish or think about doing in the future when it comes to YouTube?
I wish I hadn't lost my partnership because my channel was going places, but I still feel like it might. But I wish I had a better camera sometimes, only sometimes. I do love filming with my phone. It's very convenient. Now it's not because there's no audio on it half the time, but I've always wanted to just, I don't know, do just collab with people like in my area, but there's like nobody. But I live in Virginia, land of nobody.
Welcome to my world.
Oh,
too,
no, Maddie Post is there in Virginia.
Oh, that works.
Yeah, well, she and I never met up, and I was like, well, maybe she doesn't want to meet me, but that's fine. She lives 15 minutes away from me.
Oh, no way.
Oh, this is perfect. We got to hook you two up.
Well, yeah, we'll have to talk to you.
Well, we do talk. I talk sometimes, I guess, but we were going to meet at a musical, but it didn't happen. I was like, no, there's too many people. I didn't see you. And but yeah, I don't know. I like to do skits and stuff with people, but I don't like to do them myself on my channel because I am not very good with the putting it together or writing a script. I can't write a script to save my life. I'm like, I can do the acting for you, and I've done some for people, but I can't put it together. I'm like, I'll do it for you, but I don't expect you to have it on my channel because it's not happening. But yeah, I like to do little things by myself, like talking to myself. I have videos like that. I don't know. I just wish my channel would get a little bigger than it is, but that's fine. I like where I'm at, though, to be honest. It's fine.
you like where you are now, but you want to get bigger later on.
I would like it, but I'm not going to pressure anything. I'm gonna be like,
start doing Minecraft videos. There you go.
No.
I won't play that game. It won't happen. People tried. I said, I'm not playing that game.
So are you thinking about doing a makeup channel? I saw one of your last videos that you're talking about doing a makeup channel to help with your Mary Kay line.
Yep. I do want to do makeup videos, and everybody wants me to do them. But I feel as though my viewers, I don't have enough girl viewers that they would want to see it on my daily videos. Mm-hmm. Like having just a makeup day, I think that would make them bored or they wouldn't like it. Guys just tend to not like makeup channels. But I was thinking of making just a separate channel just for that where I could upload maybe once a week or maybe once every 2 weeks at first because I am doing the daily videos, which is time consuming. But I would love to do makeup videos because I know a lot of people I know are on the internet and they will never see me in person. So this is a way for them to get tips from me. So if they go on my Mary Kay website, they know how to use the products that are on the website.
So, do you have any good makeup tips for Steve? I mean, obviously, he's not all this, but he does need some work.
Maybe some concealer or something.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well,
just a paper bag might work well for you, Steve.
I wouldn't say that.
Oh, I would, though.
Yeah. We've known Steve way too long. We could say whatever we want.
Oh my goodness.
So you also have a blog site. Do you want to talk about that a little bit?
Oh yeah, my website that my husband thinks I never use. Yes. He paid for it and helped me put it together. He was like, you need to make sure you post regularly on here, and did that ever happen? Not really. I'm sitting here like, I'm gonna make posts every day, and it's just like my diary. It just went away. So I get on there, and I want to post regularly. But if I just been looking for comments and like feedback, and if I don't get anything, I'm like, nobody's reading it, so why am I posting here? But it's allthelostones.com, and it's, yeah, my screen name.com. It's so exciting. But but I have been posting just things, thoughts that are in my head, kind of like a diary. It's like peeking into my mind, because whenever I type something, it's always right from my heart on in right to the screen. I don't read it and then redo it. I just go with it. And most people don't do that. They're like, no, you should reread and proofread. No, I just go. If I said it, then I must have meant it.
So, yeah, exactly.
It's been interesting. That one, it started out pretty good. Like, I got comments and feedback, and then it just went away. But I'm getting back into it again, and it's pretty cool. I wrote a post today, which I wrote while I was at Starbucks, and it was pretty cool. And I was like, oh, I wrote something. I got all excited. I was like, look at that. I actually did something with my time.
Now, let's say somebody is getting into vlogging. They're new to YouTube. Do you have any tips for someone just getting started in terms of subject or what to talk about or maybe possibly what camera to buy? And I personally think maybe the video camera isn't all that important. I mean, everyone has a cell phone that has like 1080p video these days. But what about subject? What should they look into?
I think if you want to get views, the best way to get views and the way I got most of mine is from video responses to topics that you find interesting. Like, I did a lot of video responses. My most viewed videos are from HemiJeep19 video responses and Kevin Kraft video responses. I would hear a subject, so I would speak on it and give my, you know, 2 cents. Which those, if you're looking for views, definitely video response, talk about the most popular subject, and that's how you gain views. I would say the hardest thing is don't, like with YouTube and starting out, is the haters. And I do believe you shouldn't let them really get to you, because most of them are saying the same thing to everybody, and they're just on there to hate on everybody.
So exactly. They're not so creative. We have one of those right now. We got creative people.
So, Katie, what is your favorite YouTube channel? Do you have a dirty little secret channel like you don't want anyone to know about? Like what you watch? No. Like it's like.
I watch iJustine all the time. I'm like obsessed with her. I have, oh my God, this is going to be horrible, but I'm going to say it anyway. I have, you know how people dream of YouTubers? Well, I dream of iJustine and going to LA and going to the mall with her. Like, I have this reoccurring dream that this is going to happen. And everybody's like, it's not going to happen. I'm like, she becomes my friend and we go to the mall, leave me alone. You know, it's the silliest thing, but she's like, the one person I think I've consistently watched since I started watching YouTube videos.
Oh, nice.
But I do, I don't know. I watch Fred sometimes, and like in a real annoying orange, and everybody gives me stuff for that. They're like, why are you watching them? They're so stupid. I'm like, no, they're funny. I love them. Leave me alone.
And there's thousands of others out there that watch the same thing. They find it funny.
I know.
Yeah.
I think it's almost time. Sorry to cut everyone off. It's time to wrap the show, though. We're at our 20-minute mark almost. So if you guys are interested in the Quad Spot in any way, shape, or form, and if you're not, you better get in it. But check on us all on the social media sites. They're linked at thequadspot.com. There's the links to our Facebook page, which we really don't like. The Twitter page, you can follow us there. But the best one of them all is Google+, where you can hang out with us. And Jay's all this.
All the time. Yes. I mean, all this, all the time.
So find us on all that stuff and all that jazz. And of course, we've got the show schedule there. We've got the important part is Be on the Show page, where you can submit to be on the show. Or if you know of anyone else that wants to be in the show, submit them as well. And, you know, we're here every Tuesday and Friday. Friday, we do a live show, so check out us on YouTube, and you could be part of the audience. We may set up a chat room or something at thequadspot.com for a better chat with the video embed, so keep an eye on that as well. Jay, am I missing anything here?
Yes, we're also wanting to give our special thanks to Katie for being on our show. It was lovely having you on.
Don't forget to
check her out and subscribe to her channel, All the Lost Ones.
Yep.
And you can find out what's so maybe about Katie.
Yeah.
Also, Also on the quadspot.com, there's a donate button so we can get Steve some good makeup.
Yes.
Yes. I want the whole line of Mary Kay.
So
I'll buy from you, Katie, okay?
Yay. Thanks.
And also, don't forget to click on that donate button because, you know, we're still trying to recover from Steve's therapy and everything else from him being in prison and blowing up.
Therapy.
All our
money. I'm fine. I'm fine, really.
And on that note, tune in next week.